But it's not just genes. Genes can interact with your environment, and that's the purpose of this slide, is to show you very quickly a paper published a year ago by Richard Todd, who died suddenly shortly after publishing this paper, one of our great psychiatric geneticists in St. Louis. What you are seeing here is children who were genotyped to see whether or not they had that DAT gene I just mentioned and another risk gene. A plus means you got the gene, a minus means you didn't. Now the top line, you see those Y's and N's? That's whether or not your mother smoked during her pregnancy with you. I want you to look all the way over here, right side. If you got both of these genes and your mother smoked cigarettes, you are 8 times more likely to get this disorder than anybody who had either one of those causes. That is a gene by toxin interaction. And we have now found the same thing for alcohol. So some ADHD is the result of both a genetic predisposition of risk and the fact that the mother may have consumed a toxin during the pregnancy of that child. We know that genetic research is the fastest moving area of research right now in ADHD research. Out of all areas of study, this is the one that is moving so quickly. There are 100 articles a year published on this subject alone, right? What can we expect from this rapidly advancing study? We can expect to do genetic testing to help with diagnosis. We can expect to start subtyping you on the kind of ADHD you probably have. This is going to give us a better idea of what you are at risk for, because we are already beginning to label and detect that these genes carry risk for other disorders, not just ADHD. For instance, that DAT gene that regulates that transporter is a predictor of nicotine addiction. We also know that these genes are going to interact with each other and with toxins in the environment, so that's going to help explain why some people got ADHD. And as you see here, it may help in predicting drug response. And notice we now have a paper just published within the last year that shows that whether or not your child responds to behavior modification is partly related to some of these genes. Sensitivity to psychological treatment may be in part genetically mediated. Expect to see new drugs being developed just for these genes, and new psychosocial treatments may be developed for certain genetic subtypes. How cool is that? I would want families, therefore, to leave my office understanding that ADHD does not arise out of the family or from social causes, and especially to understand that these things that are very popular in the media and among many uninformed parents are not causes of ADHD for the most part. Not the least of which is television. TV and video game playing are not causing short attention spans. If I hear this again in the media, I'm going to throw up. This is now taken as gospel. It is mere folklore. There is no evidence that human attention spans have changed at all. What is changing is the amount of media you can distract yourself with if you so choose. But it doesn't mean that this is causing a short attention span. You've just got more media to pay attention to. Okay? And, of course, if you are easily distracted and you don't like to read for pleasure or sustain your attention to things, you got a lot of choices out there. So we do know that people with ADHD watch television more, play video games more, use the internet more, talk on their cell phones more, text message and Twitter more than other people do. That doesn't mean these things cause their ADHD. It's the other way around. ADHD leads you to select these as leisure activities because they're so engaging. We know that food additives don't cause this disorder, but about 1 in 20 ADHD children could be exacerbated by a little bit of these things in their diet, but it's a minor, trivial scientific finding. You don't need to go changing your child's diet as a means of dealing with ADHD. And by the way, that includes supplements like omega-3s, which were recently found to benefit less than 25% of ADHD. Only the SCT inattentive type appeared to benefit. It was modest, it was trivial, but it was kind of interesting. But ADHD combined type did not appear to benefit much from fish oil. That's a nice randomized trial published in Sweden just about 2 months ago. And of course, we know that child rearing has nothing to do with it. So I would want the family to understand, here is a pie chart of the causes of ADHD. 65% roughly genetic, all the rest are biohazards that can provide or produce brain injuries, and there is no social factor on that list.